Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we have another question, and the question is to Brother Lotfi. Brother, tell me, how do we bring up children in this day and age in an Islamic manner?
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. You have asked a very big question. Bringing up children is a responsibility of every Muslim guardian. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made every Muslim guardian responsible for their offsprings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. O you who believe, save yourselves and your family members from the fire. وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. The fuel of this hellfire will be human beings and rocks. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And Allah also subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. Order your family to establish the salat and be patient with that. He did not say order your family to pay the zakat or do hajj or fast Ramadan, because these actions are done once a year or once in a lifetime. Whereas salat is done 5 times a day. So if your family members pray 5 times a day, they will certainly do one ibadah once a year, like zakat or Ramadan or hajj once in a lifetime. So if you look after your salat very well, you're very likely to look after the rest of the ibadat very well. That's why Allah chose the salat in this specific ayah, in Surah Taha, walillahi alhamd. And the Prophet of Islam says, كُلُّكُمْ رَاعٍ وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْئُولٌ عَنْ رَاعِيَتِهِ. Everyone of you is responsible for his subject. A leader is responsible for his subject, his nation, his community. A husband is responsible for his household. A wife, she's responsible for the household of her husband and his offsprings. So everyone has his and their duties, walillahi alhamd. How to bring them up? You do your best to bring them up as Islamically as you can. It is a big test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah says, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةً. Certainly, your wealth and your children are a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah will test you through your wealth and through your children. He tests you through your wealth. You see if you spend in His sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and through your children, the test will be how you bring them up, what you teach them and what you don't teach them. So a Muslim should start teaching his children from a very young age good manners, the manners of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he taught us, as well as teaching them how to read the Quran and Islamic studies. And they grow up learning from a very, very young age. I would say from as young as perhaps 3 or 4, mm-hmm. you start teaching them these things, walillahi alhamd. So you educate them Islamically and dunya education, walillahi alhamd, as well as you look after their health. You spend on them according to your ability, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما أتاها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not hold you accountable except for that which is within your capacity. So you spend on them in accordance to your capacity, inshallah ta'ala. And you make your family an Islamic environment, walillahi alhamd. You tell them the stories of the Anbiya, the stories of the Sahaba, the stories of the Tabi'een and the scholars of Islam. This will inspire them to take that path, inshallah ta'ala. So stories are very important to impress and to inspire our youth, because they need to know what their true identity is, because they are told many stories every day on social media platforms in their schools, stories of people who are claimed to be heroes and so on and so forth, but in reality most of them were criminals, most of them were fascists, most of them were disbelievers, hypocrites, and Allah knows their history best. So we need to prevail this issue before it's prevailed against us. So do your best, and dua is the weapon of the believer, and try to practice Islam, you and your wife, before teaching it to your children. You can't tell them to pray while you're not praying. Mm-hmm. You can't tell them to speak nicely to people while you are rude. You can't tell them to eat with their right hand and to wash their hands before eating while you don't do it yourself. So you start with yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us that إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will not change the condition of people until you change your condition yourself. So you can't expect people to do that which you advise them while you are not doing it. So you've got to start changing yourself as a parent, as a guardian. And then your children, inshallah ta'ala, if your ikhlas was good and your niyyah was good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your offsprings follow you righteously. Yeah, and the dua is one of the main solutions for bringing them up Islamically. And choose for them their friendship, of course.
Yes. definitely. And it's most important that we concentrate on ourselves, like Brother Lotfi says, and we set examples to our children, of course, and they will follow. Sometimes somebody said to me that your children, if they don't listen to you, show them and they'll follow you automatically, you know. Yeah. But sometimes when you tell your kids to do this and that, you know, some children are children at the end of the day. They listen and some don't listen. But if you set an example, a trait, then they'll say, you know what, I want to follow my father or my mother.
They will. And there is one thing that we need to know, that if you don't struggle, if you don't strive very hard in bringing up your children, there will be a very little chance of them succeeding in their religious affairs and in their dunya affairs. You need, I know a sheikh from our mashayikh, hafidhahullah, Sheikh al-Fawzan, he says, لا بد من التعب والشقاء في تربية الأولاد حتى يصبحوا صالحين. أو كما قال حفظهullah, there must be some kind of struggle and hardship that you need to go through when bringing up your children if you want them to be successful in their religion and their dunya. You have to. Spend the most precious thing you can offer your children is your time before your wealth, before anything else, is your time. That's what they need most, attention and time.
Time passes by so quick, and by the time the adults themselves, you know, and then they start making their own decisions, but based on what they've learned the whole childhood, you know. May Allah guide us with that strength and iman to show us to the children, and guide us as well at the same time. I mean. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.